Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player. Good day, all. Ira Epstein with your metals market update, and this is for Wednesday, and we are now on the 15th of November. We are at 5:01 p.m. Central Standard Time, so we're already, I know this is confusing, in Thursday's trade session on the electronic markets. And as you can see, the stock market's slipping down. If you saw President Trump, he held a news conference, and he was going to have a big announcement. I've listened to it. I don't know what the big announcement was. He's got China sending an envoy to North Korea, which is always good. Japan apparently is going to buy U.S. military hardware. That's good. He talked about the fact that the U.S. is not going into any trade deals that don't benefit the U.S. It's clear he doesn't think we have to beat the deal, but we're not going to be taken advantage of. And that was what I heard out of all that. We have big problems going on still with the tax bill. Now Senator Johnson's backed out if it stays the way it is. Susan Collins is talking of backing out. You lose one more and game could be over. We haven't heard from John McCain, and we have to hear what he's going to say as they're trying to break out the Obamacare. So what is gold or metals do in an environment like this? That's what I'm leading you to, and that's the hard part. You've had gold try to break out to the downside. Believe it or not, today it got up to 1290. It's back to 1278. It's just wild swings back and forth. As it's almost as though the high frequency boys grabbed hold of the market. Suddenly it's quite volatile. When you take a look at a weekly chart of closes, just closes, you're in a downtrend. You've got the market doing this. It's under the 18 week. You've got patterns where you've had lower closes. You haven't gotten out of pattern where you even got a lower close, and then you come up to make a close that takes out a previous spike high. Not doing that. So I view this on the longer term is still in its downtrend. The battleground on the daily area charts is still there, right doing the same thing. It is leaning on this 18-day moving average of closes in red. And remember, everything else is just closing prices, so it's going to look at the last price, which is up 40 cents, and it's trading right now just slightly over that 18-day average of closes at 1277.30. When we go to the chart action, this is what I'm talking about. You try the up, you come on down, you're coming back up. Doesn't look like much, but remember, at $100 an ounce, that's the real cost of gold. Like right now, it's up 410, so that's $40. Gets expensive. And you moved on a day like today from 1290 to 1276.5. You went from the high to the low, and you closed near the low of the day. Yesterday, by the way, day before, the market went from 1269.70 to 1283.80, continued on its travels, and then broke back. Whipsaws, all within a range. Right in here, and that's what I've been trying to point out over and over. You are not trending. If you define a trend as having higher highs and higher lows as an uptrend, I can live with that. Lower highs, lower lows for a downtrend, I can live with that. And if you got a higher high and a lower low, you don't have a trend. You got to have some type of step. You got a lower low and a higher high. I don't see a trend. I see a market that is fighting a battle in the neighborhood of the 100-day and the 18-day average of closes. I see a market that is trying to find support against lower Bollinger Bands. Remember what a Bollinger Band is. A Bollinger Band is an algorithm designed to keep the market trading within it 95% of the time. But to get a trend going, you go from sideways to up or down. And the longer a market goes sideways in these bands, the more energy it's building. Go look at the corn market right now and you get an idea of that. So you're here. You failed yesterday, which is Wednesday, the day I'm talking. Remember, we're in Thursday's trade session at the upper band, and you pulled right back to support at the 18-day average. I'm going to say this market is not trending, and momentum says that too. Momentum is going flat. In terms of the gold-silver ratio, how long have I said it's just not doing anything? It's stuck in the 75 neighborhood, and I'm going to stay with that. Seems to just be stuck there, which means silver doesn't have an edge over gold, and gold doesn't have an edge over silver. And if you come to the gold ETF, you're also seeing you got a lower low and a higher high. Now, where did this market go today? It went to 122.36, got over that upper Bollinger band, and bang, got thrown right back into the 100-day and the 18-day average of closes. It's almost a sister to the futures market right now. The mining stocks, all they've been able to do recently is come up to the 18-day average, and it seems to be failing against it. So you don't have a trend here. You've got a higher high with today over that one and a lower low, and again, momentum flat. So I'm going to call the gold market a noise market right now. It's looking for an event, and I don't know what that event will be. Back to the silver market, it pulled back to the 18-day average. It's neutral there. It's got a pattern of lower highs, lower lows. So it's bearish. The close was over the 18-day average. That neutralizes it. Momentum's flat. And I want you to keep up with this 200-day moving average of closes. When silver starts getting over that on a more regular basis, I don't know when it'll be, I will say that a lot of this could be a base in it. Maybe that's when we see the inflation come back into world economies. I don't know. Just bringing it up. In the copper market, as long as China's numbers stay poor, and they are, they're shrinking at this point. Country's not in trouble. We'd all love to see growth of 6.5-7% in what they're doing, but for where they were and where they're at now is the problem. And as one of the major consumers of copper in the world, they are, with the slowdown, putting pressure on the copper market, and you see it falling at this point in time. In the platinum market, in fact, platinum and palladium, you got to keep your eye on South Africa. You know, the takeovers, what happens to world supplies, the unrest in Zimbabwe. So I watch all that, and I think other traders do, and the platinum market's been acting pretty good. It's got the higher lows, higher highs, but, and there's a huge but, can you just take a look at the Bollinger Bands? Your total sideways action here. You cannot tell me that you've had a big uptrend in the market or anything. You had a big break in the market, and since then, you have gone sideways. This energy, the sideways action, will lead eventually to another trend. Trying to catch that one is what we're trying to do. In the palladium market, you fell back to the 18-day average after hitting the upper Bollinger band, regrouping. That's what I see this market doing. And in the dollar index, if you knew no more, and the dollar starts into a downtrend, we were talking. One of the things I'd be looking at is potential support. And I said this yesterday, at the 100-day average and the lower Bollinger band, let's call it the 93.45 mark. That's where I think the pros would take some money off the table. You got under it today, you got to 93.30, you're back to 93.72. Have you changed the downtrend? No, you haven't. They're probably waiting for this market on rallies until they see a pattern change. So we'll see what goes on. But in talking about gold and talking about Modern Trader magazine, I got something for you, a free one-year subscription to it. Now, it's normally $79.95 from them. Go to their website, subscribe to it, great. Through our relationship with them, you can get the emailed version sent out to you. And believe me, it uses a great reader. You'll feel that you're just reading it on your computer screen. It's easy as can be. And yes, it'll print out. It's got all these fabulous stories in it, different trading techniques in it. And as I said, this issue's all about Bitcoin in many different ways. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not talking futures. Bitcoin's really a cryptocurrency, right? But then there's ETFs that watch these. Then you've got the different stock plays in the mining companies. All of this. Here's gold miners looking up the earnings story, just to give you an idea. So if you're a metal buff, gold, gas, and the yen, the different cycles that come in, all there is play. Gold, nowhere to go but down. Well, that's one opinion of the market. So you take it from there. The stories, you can see how nice they look. The graphics are phenomenal, but it's chock full of news, be it the stock market, an ETF trader, a currency trader. You might want to take a look at this magazine. And then daily, they send out Modern Traders Market Focus, because it'll have the short-term stories that happen today that are going to impact the market either tonight, tomorrow. These people are writing, and you'll get an idea. That's how you keep up with what's going on. How do you get this free value from us? It's really simple. Call my staff. You can go to our website. Remember, everything's going to come to you by email. If you go to my website, you'll see a carousel of free offers. You can click up here at any time if you're watching me on YouTube, or underneath us. It says click here for Ira's free offers on many of the websites. Do so, and away you go. I'm Ira Epstein. I'll see you tomorrow.